हेलो जय रजन
सर बाला सर गुड आफ्टरनून सर
गुड आफ्टरनून
द स्क्रीन शेयरिंग ट्राई பண்ணிட்டா சலி ட்ரை ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங்
பண்ணுங்க சார் ட்ரை பண்ணுங்க
ஐ டோன்ட்
உங்களுக்கு அந்த ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் கொடுத்தாச்சு சார் கோ ஹோஸ்ட் மாத்திட்டோம் நவ யூ கேன் ஷேர் யுவர் ஸ்கிரீன் சார்
ஓகே
ஐ வில் செக் யூ நோ ப்ராப்ளம் ஓகே சார் ஃபைன் சார் ஸ்லைட் ஷேர் ஆகுது சார்
ஓகே பட் ஸ்லைட்
எஸ் சார் எஸ் சார்
ஃபைன் நவ
எஸ் சார் ரிவர்ஸ் இன்ஜினியர் ப்ராடக்ட் டிசேபிள் டிஸ் அசெம்பிளி ஓகே சார் ஓகே சார்
டாக்டர் தேகரஜன் தி மை வாய்ஸ் இஸ் கிளியர்
எஸ் சார் இஸ் ஆடிபிள் சார் கிளியரா இருக்கு சார்
ஓகே சார் ஓகே தேங்க் யூ
With your permission, we can wait for 5 to 10 minutes, sir. Let the participant has to join, sir.
Yes, yeah, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. பலகணேசன் சார்.
எஸ் ஸ்டார்ட்
சார்.
எஸ் ஷூர்.
சோ குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு ஆல். சோ ஒன்ஸ் அகைன் இட்ஸ் எ வார்ம் வெல்கம் டு ஆல் த பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் ஆஃப் எ டே 3 செஷன் 9 AST ஸ்பான்சர்ட் அட்டல் ஃபேக்கல்டி டெவலப்மெண்ட் ப்ரோக்ராம் ஆன் டிசைன் திங்கிங் ஆர்கனைஸ்டு பை டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் மெக்கானிக்கல் இன்ஜினியரிங் ஸ்ரீ மனோகர இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ். I thank Dr. G. Balaganesan sir for accepting our invitations and be part of our FD program. Thank you, sir. Now I invite Dr. G. Ganesh Kumar, Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, to introduce our speaker, Dr. G. Balaganesan.
So thank you, sir, Dr. Thyagarajan sir. So very good afternoon to all. So the first of all, this is the third day, 9th session of our ATEL FDP on design thinking. So organized by Sri Manakala Vinayar Engineering College, Puducherry. I would like to thank the college management, the respected director cum principal, Dr. VSK Vengadajalapathi sir, our beloved professor and HOD, Dr. K. Velmurugan sir. Sir, for giving the wonderful opportunity, it's a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today. Dr. G. Balaganesan sir, working as a senior technical officer at IIT Madras, Chennai. Sir is a glowing, capable AMI in Mechanical Engineering Institute of Engineers India, Kolkata, 2000. He did a ME in Mechanical Engineering, the PhD College of Technology, Coimbatore, 2003. He did PhD in Aerospace Engineering, the Indian Institute of Technology, Madras, 2013. So he is doing a research interest at present are required for in this the emerging area, especially for the material, that's an important one, especially for the composite material processing, the impact studies, the nanocomposite, the fatigue of the composite materials and the repair of the composite material. He has academic the employment. Sir is starting the career April 2003 to April 2005. He worked as a lecturer in mechanical engineering at Amity University, Chennai. At presently, the working as senior technical officer at IIT Madras, Chennai. He has more than 10 years industrial experience. It's a vast experience. The sir is in 1991 to April 2001. So worked in this production department for the various the manufacturing industries in India. So award under recognized achievement. He has got award for the securing institute of the first rank in the diploma in mechanical engineering 1991. He has received a institute fund to attend the conference to visit the various country like Germany and South Africa 2011 and 2013. He has received the excellency in the leadership award 2014 from IIT Madras. He has published more than 5 international journals. So all the journals are the reputed journals. Sir has attended more than 8 referred conferences and covered the major areas, the composite and the nanocomposite materials. So last but not least, sir has more than 6 research consultancy project, India South African intergovernmental project, the IIT Madras social the relevant project, the ISRO sponsored project, and 3 industry project. One is LNV Technology Private Limited and the Caterpillar in India, the modern the Insulator Limited sponsored project. So this is a brief introduction. I now request Dr. G. Balaganesan sir to address us the gathering.
Good afternoon to all of you. I am Dr. G. Balaganesan and I thank Mr. Thyagarajan and associate for giving nice introduction about me. So just I'm going to talk about reverse engineering and product disassembly. I was with IIT Jammu from 2018 to 2019 as assistant professor on deputation. There just I introduced a course on product disassembly. I want to discuss more about the course as well as the technology of reverse engineering. So here some of the products reverse engineered in by me and my team in the last 1 year. So if you see that the product number 1 is a composite flexible coupling used in wind turbines. So the capacity of that the flexible coupling is 2 megawatt. The power transmission is 2 megawatt and the rated RPM is 1200. and the rated torque is 16,000 Newton meter. And here there are three major parts here. One is a brake disc, so which will be the brake disc end is connected to output shaft of the gearbox. And this is the glass fiber reinforced plastic hollow shaft. And another end is of this hollow shaft is connected to torque limiter. And the torque limiter side of this coupling is connected to generator of the wind turbine. So just I will give more details about this in this talk. So this was the product indigenously developed, partly we can say reverse engineered. We'll discuss this one of the products. And another one is daylight float for fishing net. Actually, in sometime in February this year, one industry person came with a fisherman to meet me at IIT Madras. And he asked me, sir, due to the COVID in China, we are not able to get this product. So the fisherman said they use with the motorized boat, they go to deep sea and they spread their nets over the sea surface. And daytime, there will be a boundary so that other fishermen, if they're coming from other boats, so they will be able to visualize the net and they won't cross the net area. And whereas during nighttime, so then there will not be visibility. Then there will be a possibility for that other boats will cross the that area. So that for that they put this kind of daylight float in the nighttime, so that other boats will be able to find out there is a net and they won't cross. So then due to this COVID in the China, and then they were not able to import this kind of floats from China. Then he came to, sir, after this December, due to the COVID, we are not able to get this product. We are in the process of developing this. We need your help. Then I helped for mechanical part, all this making the mold for injection molding and all this product. Then I asked them to the sequence of the reverse engineering process, and they have made the mold. And finally, they brought the assembly. Then I made a connection with our electronics team in IIT Madras. So to provide the support for the sensors and other things. So it was developed successfully before our COVID. All of us know that our lockdown started 25th March. So before our COVID started, we were able to develop the product, and it is successfully implemented in Chennai by some of the companies. And the third product, all of us know that due to the COVID and the large requirement of ventilators, and we are also working for converting the Ambu bag into low-cost ventilators for some of the startup companies at IIT Madras. And I was involved to develop this nebulizer. So nebulizer also will supply air, and even normally this asthma patients, they used to use this nebulizer. And we opened up one existing nebulizer, and then we try to reverse it. So that I will talk about this in a more interesting stories are there about this nebulizer when I had experience during that time. So that I will explain to you during this presentation. And the topics covered in this talk is introduction to reverse engineering and what is the need of reverse engineering, the processes involved in reverse engineering, and what are the visual design elements in reverse engineering, what are the functional analysis to be done, and the black box system model in reverse engineering. And also just I'm going to discuss about one case study on reverse engineering. And I offered one course to IIT, offered as well as I only designed the course on product assembly. So I have given some of the details in those slides. And also I introduced one hands-on activity to the school children at IIT Madras sometime from 2013 to till date. So just I'm going to brief about that engineering is fun activity at IIT Madras. We'll see one by one. So reverse engineering, so till now we consider that it is like a cut and paste, okay. But it is more than that. So it's like if it is a mechanical engineer, it is like taking a device and analyzing its working in detail, and usually with the intention of to construct new one, developing new one, or if it is a software, developing new software program, and if it is integrated with the mechanical system as well as electrical system, so that both mechanical engineer as well as electrical engineer will be able to develop the system or develop the drawings and develop the models and making the circuit diagrams. And also it is not copying, so it is like that is the reference, so that by using that and making any other original part, and the resulting knowledge gained through the reverse engineering can be then applied to the design of similar products, so that whatever the knowledge gained in reverse engineering will be applied for similar kind of products, and capitalizing on successes and learning from the shortcomings of existing designs is the objective of the reverse engineering, so that we'll be able to understand what are the drawbacks, what are the negative aspects in the existing product, and by getting that experience we'll be able to develop new product. And engineers use this information to prepare documentation, generate electronic data models, and construct new or improved device or equipment or program. The reverse engineering is helping us to develop a systematic approach to think about the engineering design of devices and systems, and also we'll be able to get some kind of mental data bank of the design solutions, so that when we do dissection and when we do reverse engineering, we'll be able to understand the things. And why does industry do reverse engineering? So the original, so there are many cases for going for reverse engineering. So one of the case, the original manufacturer of your product no longer produces the product, or replacement of the parts for the product. So for example, if you take a car, so the car produced in some 2005 or 2006, so they may not manufacture a particular model of the car, and the whatever the parts needed, so they will not make it. So that we hope. So there will be some kind of small scale or medium scale industry. So they will develop the part and they will be able to, they are not the OEM, but they do reverse engineering, so to meet the demand of old cars or old items. And suppose if you want to eliminate bad feature of the product, so we need to reverse engineer it. And also if you want to improvise the good features of the product also, you have to do reverse engineering. And also to analyze the good and bad features of the competitors of the product. Suppose if you want to understand the competitor's product and to address those bad features of competitor's product. So for that also, we need to do reverse engineering. And also to create CAD models and documentation. Suppose if the particular equipment or model is made some 30, 40 years before, so at that time there was no the tooling, advanced tooling, that modeling tooling. So there, if you want to make a new product, then we need to do we have to make the model from the existing product, and also we with the help of CNC we'll be able to make it. And also if you update the obsolete materials or antiquated manufacturing processes. Suppose if take the material is nowhere is not permitted to use, some kind of plastics or some harmful materials. So there also we need to do reverse engineering. We have to update with a new material, with advanced material. If they give a negative effect to the environments. So there we need to say some kind of plastics are to be avoided. And there if it is not allowed, government agencies are not allowed to use that material, then we have to think of going with the advanced material. So these are the points where essentially we need to do reverse engineering. And if you look at the industry, it's very common in fields like software engineering, entertainment, automotive, consumer products, microchips, chemicals, electronics, and mechanical designs. So for example, if you see the new machine in the market, and so for example, if you get some product from some country, developed the country, then if you want to develop it, if you want to make it our own, so then we need to get the product, or we need to then we need to disassemble it, and we have to understand how it was built, how it works. and if you see any chemical industry, so they have to do reverse engineering to defeat the patent on a competitor's manufacturing process, to understand the composition, to understand the manufacturing process. They have to do it. If it is a civil engineering, and they have to redesign, or they have to copy the design, and also they have to understand the shortcomings of the bridges or buildings. So then that will give an opportunity to overcome the failure, catastrophic failures. And software engineering, a good source code is often a variation of other good source code, so where it is copied. And in some conditions, so designers give a shape to the idea by using a clay or plaster or wood or foam rubber. But essentially, there is a need of CAD model to enable the manufacturing of the part. But as the parts become more organic in shape, and designing in CAD may be challenging or impossible, and there is no guarantee that the CAD model will be acceptable close to the sculpted model. So the reverse engineering provides a solution to this problem, because the physical model is source of information for the CAD model. So this is also referred to as the part to CAD process, so that clay model can be converted into CAD process. And reverse engineering in industry. So reverse engineering enables the duplication of an existing part by capturing the components, physical dimensions, features, and material properties. But before attempting this reverse engineering, a well-planned life cycle analysis and a cost-benefit analysis should be conducted to justify the reverse engineering projects. Just I want to tell my experience here. Just in the beginning, I showed three products, that coupling, composite coupling, then this one, the nebulizer. So here the nebulizer, so one of my friends who is the wholesale dealer of medical equipment, so during the COVID time he was very busy, and every day, even lockdown also, he was opened in Chennai, and in the very busy area, and he to open his outlet from morning 9 to evening 7. So he opened his outlet due to this essential services provision, and there he invited me that just we there is a huge demand in few products, just I want to find out somebody in local to develop these products. And he gave one of the products, he gave three products, one of the products is nebulizer. Then he gave me the complete pack, and then I told him what was your purchase price. He told me that at that time we'll discuss later. Then I also told him, okay, let me find out our price, that price that we can supply to you. And he initially told me that right now you take, I need 1,000 numbers. You take these 1,000 numbers order, and you give your breakup and the cost also. Then he gave one condition. The manufacturing should be done by one of the startup companies of IIT Madras, and the marketing will be done by me, and the product that the model and made the model should be in his company name. Then I with one of students, then we dismantled and we found out the parts. So there are two parts, the major parts. So one is a motor of 75 watts, and another one was a small recuperating compressor. And the parts inside were made by one of the companies in the world, reputed companies in the world. And also we went through all their websites and everything. And also other things, other than that, only plastic casing, and there are tubes to fit into the face of the patient. And these were major parts, that the motor and the pump. Then I tried with some of the people in Chennai. So that I thought of promoting somebody who is doing this electrical rewinding, so that this is a small motor. Then I asked him, then can you duplicate this? Can you make this so that there are huge orders? So that if you agree, then if you are okay, then I can give you some 1,000 numbers in the beginning. So then immediately he said, sir, okay, sir, I will go through. Then I asked him if you need any manufacturing support or making the drawings of the parts, and I will help you. So only thing, since already you are doing this winding or rewinding of motors for last 20 years, so why cannot you think as become a manufacturer of small motors? So whereas we are importing from other countries. Then he said, okay, sir, I will try. Then I tried 2 to 3 days. Then after that, he did not respond to my call. Then immediately I called one of my friends in Coimbatore. So Coimbatore is the area where the large this pump motors manufactured in India. I think particularly in South India. So Coimbatore is a hub, industrial hub, where they make large number of motors. KSB, there are many motor manufacturer, pumps manufacturer. Then one of my friends in Coimbatore, I told him that I need to develop this kind of motors. So can you find out some of the small motor manufacturer in Coimbatore? Then he spent about 2 days, and he went. He discussed with many small manufacturers, and finally he came to me that they say that cost of the motor is about 700 rupees. If it is, if the requirement is 1000 numbers, okay. So then addition to that, we need to make small compressor, the reciprocating compressor. The motor output shaft is connected to the crank and cylinder mechanism, and it has to operate the compressor. So then I saw that the break even is very high. Then I went through the websites and to find out this motor and the compressor. So the same company who supplies motors to the many other companies, for all the nebulizers making companies. So they the cost of their motor as well as the compressor is only 273 rupees in Indian cost in India. So 273, and minimum ordering quantity is 1000 numbers. So then I worked out other the mold cost for casing and other parts. Then I estimated I saw this MRP in the cover is about 2700 rupees. So then I thought that the product cost around 900 rupees. So normally if you look at any product in the market, the 40% of the product cost is manufacturing cost. So I made that assumption that 900 rupees is the product cost. Then plus for developing the tooling for initial molding, injection molding, other things. So I put another 500 rupees for first 1000 numbers. So then remaining, I thought if he gives further order, so that we can stick to the price of 900 rupees per product. And then we thought we made a breakup this way, so that 273 rupees the motor and compressor cost, so plus with the importing cost will be another 30-40 rupees, so that 300 rupees will be the motor and compressor, and developing other items that cost of other plastic parts, so another 100 rupees including assembly. So we thought that 400 rupees will be the 400 to 450 rupees will be the manufacturing cost, and the margin will be another 250 rupees. So that 250 rupees, and we can say that in between that manufacturer and traders, then another 200 rupees. I thought of giving him. I told him that we'll be able to give this price. Then he said no. So if you are able to supply for 400 rupees. And if you take another 300 rupees as a margin, so if you are able to supply for 700 rupees from the beginning, then you will be able to get the order. So why I am telling is before attempting reverse engineering, that we have to do the cost and benefit analysis. So this is very, very important. Even if I do make for 250 rupees margin, if I make 1000 numbers, so you can see the how much amount I will get it. And also the life cycle. So now, because of this COVID, everywhere we are getting this nebulizer. Then after COVID, we don't know the market. So that's the reason we need to check the product life cycle as well as the cost benefit analysis. And also reverse engineering is typically cost effective only if the items to be reverse engineered reflect a high investment or will be reproduced in larger quantities. So that break even is very, very important. So reverse engineering, if your product may be attempted, even if it is not a cost effective, if the part is absolutely required and is a mission critical to your system. For example, same thing, even COVID during this time in the beginning. So what we did, many of our students based startup companies. So after getting the experience from Italy, there was large requirement of ventilators. But whereas India, situation was not there. But initially we were afraid of that. And we got all these AMBU bags and we developed different mechanisms to inflate the air to the patients. So there, for such conditions, even if there is no that cost effective, but we need to develop such kind of products by reverse engineering. The
requirement. That's one requirement. And the time and cost effective way to produce models and products, that is also very, very important. So the process of reverse engineering is particularly cost effective. The items to be reverse engineered represent a significant financial investment or will be reproduced in large quantities. I think already I discussed. And also we need to compress the life cycle. We go to see the product development cycle. Say for example, this COVID, so many of them made, you know, all of you know the face shield. So face shield is another product where I was involved sometime in the first week of April. And initially, one of our startup company students, we made this, they made with a plastic frame. And the OHP sheet was used as a shield. And they have made a mold for, initially they made using 3D printer, few parts. And in 3D printer, it's difficult to get break even. And also they developed a mold in the beginning and the, including molding mold cost and the 3D printed parts in the beginning. So they initially the cost of the face shield was 100 rupees. Sometime in first or second week of the April, they sold for 100 rupees to hospitals and other essential places. So then later, many people came to the market and the same person after 2 weeks, they fixed the price for 50 rupees. Then I was involved with one of my friends in industry. Then he asked me to help him. So then we helped him to design the mold and get the OHP sheets and other things. So then the cost came to 40 rupees and then it came to 25 rupees. And yesterday I got call from the same, the wholesale dealer from Chennai market. He told me, so can you help me to get 1,000 numbers of face shield? Then immediately I contacted the same person where he made, he stocked nearly 7,000 numbers of this face shield. Then he told me, then this man, the wholesale dealer, he told me that I am getting for 15 rupees per shield. And it should be less than that. Then we again, the manufacturer is my close friend and I asked him for the break even. Then he told me that actual cost for the face shield, so that OHP sheet is 5 rupees. So on the punching, maybe another 50 rupees, making a punching holes to fix in the plastic frame. And the plastic frame, after getting the mold cost in the break even, the cost of the plastic frame is only 2.5 rupees. And the cost of the face shield is only 7.5 rupees. And he was able to supply for 12 rupees 50 paise for the minimum number of some 500,000 numbers. So this way that cost will decrease over a period of time after meeting the break-even point. And a 3D model can be quickly captured in digital form and remodeled if necessary or exported for a variety of manufacturing methods like a 3D printing or vacuum casting or CNC machining. And if you see the reverse engineering processes, so these are the processes, the prediction and observation, disassembly, analyze, test and documentation. We'll see one by one. So the prediction, and we have to see what is the purpose of this product. We have to see the purpose and how does it work? And what market was it designed to appeal to? And we have to list some of the design objectives of the product. And also we have to list some of the constraints that may have influenced the design. So what are the constraints in the design? We have to list it. This is the prediction. And observation. So how do you think it works? And how does it meet design objectives overall? And why is it designed the way it is? Why not in different way? So this thing and all we need to observe during observation. And during disassembly, so we have to understand how, we have to ask these questions. How does it work? How is it made? And how many parts are there in the assembly? How many parts are moving parts? And how many are stationary parts? And any surprises? Is there any challenging or any criticality in the parts? So these things we need to understand during disassembly. And analyze. So we have to carefully examine and analyze the subsystems like a structural, mechanical, and electrical, and develop annotated sketches. We have to make a kind of even freehand sketches, and that include measurements and notes on components, system design, safety, and controls. And again, we need to, suppose if you do disassembly, then again we go to reassemble it, and we go to operate to understand, to observe its performance in terms of functionality and ergonomic and projected durability. So one product we just developed during one more product we developed in this COVID is foot operated sanitizer dispenser. So in the beginning, the cost of the foot operated sanitary device, the devices developed by many of these small companies in steel, the minimum cost was 1,200 rupees, 1,400, 1,500, like that. So we developed a foot operated sanitizer for 220 rupees. So we completely took all plastic parts, and we used a PVC pipe, and we used only a metal rod inside to actuate it, so that pedal force will be converted into the pressing force and the plunger. And the cost was that including mold cost. We considered the mold, development of the mold. There were about 10 plastic parts. We used the ABS plastic as the raw material, and PVC is a structural element, and metal rod, and there is a spring. With that, we are able to develop for 220 rupees with the margin. And we have done that. We have done fatigue test also. We operated it for 1 lakh cycles to understand the capability of the product at higher fatigue cycles. And documentation. So we need to see that inferred the design goals and inferred constraints. So what are the constraints in the product? And also we need to we have to understand the functionality, geometry, and materials, what kind of materials used in the product. And also we have to make a schematic diagrams. And also we have to list the materials, components, critical components, flaws, and successes. Also we need to identify and refinement that might enhance the product's usefulness. And also wherever possibility, we need to upgrade, and we need to make the changes. So for example, in the nebulizer, and all of us know that this asthma patient, when they fix this nebulizer and the nose, so there in the hospital staff, they will come and just count the time, and they will come, then they will come after 10 minutes or 15 minutes and they remove it. Also they tell that you tell me after 10 minutes. Okay, so then we thought of implementing small timer, so that when it is started, the timer will be on. Then it will count, and after 10 minutes, it may stop. So that we thought of introducing this small feature, additional feature in the nebulizer, adding small cost, so to give better the feature of the product. So these are the visual design elements for any, even this is for this is applicable for a new product design as well as reverse engineering. So like line, color, and form and shape of the product, space, texture, and value. We'll see one by one. So here the types line. So normally vertical lines represents dignity, formality, stability, and strength. And horizontal lines represents calm, peace, and relaxation. And diagonal lines represents action, activity, excitement, and movement. Curved lines represents freedom, the natural, having the appearance of softness, and creates a soothing feeling or mood. And if you see the colors as a immediate effect on the product, and warm colors, so the reds, oranges, yellows are warm colors, and very cool colors are blues, purples, greens, and colors can affect how humans feel and act. And form and shape, the typical forms are squares, circles, ellipses, ovals, rectangles, and triangles. And also the space. So here the space should be effectively designed, and we can reduce unwanted space. And if you see that types of this one space, and so open type, uncluttered spaces, crammed, busy, and unused, and good use of space. So effective use of space is very important. So if you see the same nebulizer, so inside there are only two parts, okay, but volume wise more than that. If you see, the effective volume is only 30 to 35%, 30 to 40%. So remaining 60% of volume is occupied, but to give the complete shape of the product, we need to have that kind of size, so texture. So even it gives some feeling to us, and smooth surface reflects more light, and therefore it's a more intense color, and rough surface absorbs more light and therefore appears darker. And functional analysis, so after a product has been selected, a non-destructive functional analysis is performed. So here we can identify the purpose of the product, and also we have to do observation of the with reference to function of the product, and also we need to write it. We have to arrive this what are the inputs and what are the outputs to the product in the during the functional analysis. So for example, if you take your toothbrush, okay, so the purpose of the toothbrush is to clean teeth, gums, to prevent the tooth and gum decay. And water and a cleansing paste are also used in conjunction with the toothbrush. And here so you can see that figure, the toothbrush with the paste inside, and here you can see the various parts of the toothbrush. Battery at the bottom to store the energy, so that gripping area, and also wherever necessary we need to make the annotated sketches, and we need to write all this functionality of the parts, and also we have to write it down, the sequential operation and function of each part. And the black box model, to find out what are the items are going inside, what are the items are coming out. So for example, if you take the product function, so the inputs and output, so that it's we'll get some kind of balance from it. So also it will help us to identify the internal components in processes. So here, and for example, if you take your toothbrush, so that the inputs are hand motion, toothpaste, water, and energy. The outputs are the sound, during brushing the sound, and there will be a small heat generation due to the friction, and the waste and the clean teeth and gums are the outputs. So the case study of reverse engineering that I did in the last year. So I want to tell you about sometime in the April 2019. And you see that one of my friends was manufacturing wind electric generator components, and he asked me then that some of the foreign companies they make the composite stuff. Since my area of research is on composites, he told that wind electric generators, the couplings are nowadays coming with the composites. So in India, no one is manufacturing. Then in 2019 January, I visited one of the exhibitions in Mumbai for composite materials. I saw some of the companies in India, they are making the composite shafts for power transmission. Then actually here the advantage, so if you use the metal shaft, the weight of this shaft, that coupling, is about 80 kg. If you go with composite, it will be only 20 kg, even during maintenance. So in the, just imagine the tower is about 80 to 100 meters. So that lifting this, there is no crane inside there in the nacelle of wind electric generator. So there for lifting this 80 kg, they need more manpower. So that this is one of the advantages during maintenance. And he told me that is it possible to help me to develop this product. Then I agreed. And then since I was at IIT Jammu at that time, then that particular manufacturer was at Delhi. And the company who is intended to manufacture this coupling is in Chennai. and they were making a steel coupling with both the brake disc and the torque limiter. So here, if you look at this figure, the brake disc and the torque limiter, and this is the GFRP hollow shaft. So already they were making the brake disc as well as the torque limiter with the steel shaft. Then here the challenge is only to make GFRP shaft. So it has to withstand 2 MW. The power transmission is 2 MW, and the rated speed is 1200 RPM, and the rated torque is 16,000 Newton meter. And the maximum torque, we need to test maximum torque of 30,000 Newton meter. Since I was in Jammu, then en route I went to Delhi to that particular company who is manufacturing that's composite shafts. I went there, then he said he is able to help to make it. Then the order has come, and so I was involved to coordinate for making the GFRP shaft. And we have given the order to the particular company. Then they were asking some 1,25,000 rupees for tooling for making this GFRP tube. And then our customer is another windmill manufacturing company. And the customer wanted to witness the product in Delhi. So they want to see how the shaft is made. And they wanted to understand, those who are working on composite material, they know this composite material, that particularly fiber reinforced plastic, is made up of glass fiber and resin, the poly thermoset resin. So the glass fiber, the strength depends upon glass fiber and thermoset resin. So this particular company, that our customer, wanted to see the manufacturing of the shaft. They wanted to understand what kind of fibers they use, what kind of resin they use. We need data sheet of the fiber. We need the test reports of the fiber. We need a test report of the resin. And we need the sequence of the operation they follow. So we want to evaluate on the product manufacturing. Then we contacted this particular tube manufacturer in Delhi. Then he said, no, we cannot allow your customer to visit our premises. And we cannot allow you also to see the manufacturing process. No, this is our customer's requirement to get the data sheet of the raw materials and other things. Without that, we cannot proceed the work. So we need to meet the requirement of our customer. Then he said, okay, then I will arrange a CCTV in the manufacturing process. And you can see in our conference room, and you can see the process. And also, I won't allow you to see. I will allow only your customer to see through CCTV. Then the customer was demanding to see, no, without seeing that data set of the raw material, I cannot accept the product. Then I was with that customer. We were there nearly 3 hours. We have made a lot of conversation with the company. No, this is a part of any vendor development, and the customer has to witness the product manufacturing. He has to see the raw material. This will not be possible like that. Finally, he told me that, so to manufacture this composite shaft in India, so I have spent my 3 years time with one of this Netherlands company. I spent 3 years in the Netherlands to understand the technology, and I don't want anyone to duplicate my product here to make it in India, so that I won't allow you to see the process. Then we have spent some 1.5 lakhs and all these things, and we gave for order for few first few number, five numbers. Then the customer, that our customer, wanted to cancel that. Then we try to convince the customer, then you please be there, then we'll find out alternate source in India. Then I challenged the particular person that so that you spent 3 years to understand to make this composite shaft. So I challenge you, within 3 months, I will make the shaft and I will load in the windmill. Then what we did, we tried to find out the composite shaft manufacturer, the tube manufacturer in India. Finally, we found out one, the plumb and winding machine manufacturer, as well as the composite shaft manufacturer in Hyderabad. Then I went to him and I told him that we want to develop this. He was alumni of IIT Madras 1976 batch, BTEC alumni. Then he agreed to help. And also initially we thought of buying the filament winding machine to make our own shaft. He said, no, since your requirement is only 20 numbers per month, so why do you waste on machine? So that I will be able to make the hollow tubes, hollow shaft, and I will supply it to you. then we understood that this GFRB tube, we have to fix a metal sleeves to fix the brake disc as well as to fix with the torque limiter. Then we made attempt with many of this bonding medium manufacturer. We contacted them and we found out the various, we made a comparison of various bonding medium, bonding between the GFRP and metal sleeve. So then we have made some kind of test, lap shear test and bonding test and all, debonding test and all. So finally we arrived one company's product and we have made the, so we bought only the tube from this, the tube manufacturer, and the bonding technology developed by our own the unit. And we developed this shaft and finally we assembled it. And we tested for 37,000 Newton meter. So we invited our customer and we demonstrated testing. So here also that the competitor who is manufacturing this GFR, the composite shaft, he was saving only 16,000 Newton meter testing capacity, the testing machine. Then testing for 30,000 Newton meter, he was asking another 5 lakhs rupees to invest on new testing equipment to test for 30,000 Newton meter. Then we have made our own system, okay? So with arrangement and on existing equipment or machine, and we tested for 30,000 Newton meter, and our customer witnessed, and he was very happy to see the torque levels, everything. And finally, it was within the third month, it was loaded in one of the windmill sites in India. So this was a small brief about the reverse engineering of one of the very critical part in wind electric generators. And also one challenge we had, those who are working on composite, they know about the volume fraction. Whereas in imported the composite shaft, the volume fraction of the fiber, the reinforcement was 82%. But India, none of this composite manufacturer, the tube manufacturer, were not able to achieve this volume fraction of the fiber 82%. So we were able to achieve only 73%. But anyhow, based on the strength requirement, we slightly redesigned the diameters and suitably to transmit this power. Okay, so so this is about reverse engineering of one of the important products in the last 1 year with my support. And now I'm going to talk about the product disassembly course that I introduced at IIT Jammu. And also the product disassembly is one of the major steps in reverse engineering process. Okay, so actually we have given this course name as a product assembly. So product disassembly is a negative terminology. We don't want to give that the product disassembly as the course title. That's why we gave the title as a product assembly. Okay, so before going to that course, just I want to tell small story about one particular incident, one case. So the Mr. Karthikeya Mangalam, he was a final year student of IIT Kanpur and electrical engineer. So he was traveling from Russia to India after attending a conference in Geneva. He realized that someone was, at that time he was 21 years old. I think this came in the newspaper, you can see later. And he was 21 years old at that time. And he was noticing something that two rows behind one passenger was needing some medical help. Okay. So the passenger, according to the student, he suffered from type 1 diabetes and he forgot to get insulin pump. And actually he left that insulin pump at the Moscow airport security check. Okay. So, and his the blood sugar level was risen and to the dangerous level. And also he was in some critical stage. Then they were announced for any medical practitioner in the flight. Then one medical practitioner in the same flight, he's also a diabetes patient and had insulin as well as medicine. And he was trying to inject the insulin to the patient. The insulin cartridge did not fit with the doctor's insulin pen. And sugar level was increasing, and suddenly they wanted to do for emergency landing. Okay, so then at that time only the Karthikeya went to patient's seat and saw the doctor struggling to adjust man's insulin cartridge into his pen. Then immediately, so he wanted to fix it. He wanted to help the doctor to repair the insulin pen. Okay, so then he using the airplane Wi-Fi, so he found out the engineering drawing of this insulin pen. And also he found out that the insulin pen was missing with one small spring. So then he requested air hostess to get the ballpoint pen from the passengers they have. Then they announced and they got one ballpoint pen. He disassembled and he took that ballpoint pen and he assembled with doctor's insulin pump. Then after 15 minutes, the device was ready and the doctor was able to inject the medicine to the patient, and now the patient has stabilized, and then they stopped emergency landing, and finally they have reached Delhi, and the passenger was taken to the hospital, and that passenger thanked the Karthikeya Mangala and invited him there. So this is a small story. What is the importance of the disassembly? So I used to tell students the importance of this hands-on engineering courses in the engineering curriculum. Okay. So then the product disassembly, I think now we know that it's like a tear down of the product is a major step in the reverse engineering. So it uncovers principles behind how the product works. And also it is a fun. Tear a part a product and but nothing will be accomplished. The data is not collected during the process, and to gather this data we'll use a product product parts breakup chart, and how do the parts interact, and what are the good and bad features of the product's form, product's function, and what has caused the product to succeed or fail. So what is the success or what is the reason for success as well as the failure of the product, and whether the materials are appropriate, and what manufacturing process was used. So what is the estimated cost of the product? So these are the information we have to get, and the reason for disassembly, to analyze an existing product and determine the components and their relationships. To determine the strength and weakness of the parts, to understand how it works, to develop the documentation, and the levels. So the levels of analysis during disassembly: system-wide analysis, subsystem dissection analysis. So if it is a big product, so the big product will be divided into number of sub-assembly. Again, the sub-assembly will be disassembled to understand the individual component analysis. So here, sub-wide analysis, the customer requirements, the engineering requirements, and functional specification, and prediction of the subsystem and components. And subsystem dissection analysis includes that document of disassembly, define the subsystem, determine subsystem, functional specifications, and determine subsystem physical and mathematical. If there is any mathematical or energy balance or energy principles are there, that also we need to understand. And if you see the individual component analysis, so we have to repeat to the individual component and define the component with the selection of material and the fabrication process. And we have to suggest alternate design system components and materials. Okay, so for example, if you take a small kitchen scale, but nowadays we use only a digital one to understand the mechanical system, just we have taken this as the reference. Here, if you want to dissection it, so you can see the parts. So the top plate and the stem and rivets and the spring, nut and threaded are the parts, and a few more parts, links. There are three links, link 1, 2, 3, and you can see the readout panel and the bottom cover and the body cover. So these are the parts. In this scale. So here, when we disassemble it, so we'll gather the information regarding the parts and the research chart. We can include all the details, and we can understand the material properties. So you can see this chart where you can find out number of columns, to document this disassembly process, the product name, the group number, tear down date and time, and part name and the quantity, the dimensions and functions, material and the texture and finish, interaction with other parts, general notes. So when during the course of this product assembly, we ask the students to make, for if they take one product, and they have to collect all this information during this assembly of the product. And also these are all the tools used for disassembly of the product. So the process is measurements and record the data, create wherever necessary. They have to create the thumbnail sketches, and also they have to make pictorial sketches, which are extremely important at this stage to show how the part is assembled and how the mechanism works. And they have to compare the theory and hypothesis of how the product functioned to its actual operate during the actual operation. And these are the 10 exercises. So there are 14 weeks for 14 weeks semester. We gave on 10 exercises. Very first class, we gave introduction and we gave all the safety features to be maintained in the laboratory. And we gave outline about the course. And the 10 exercise, you can see the 10 products. So the iron box, hydraulic jack, electrical wiring of staircase circuit, foot pump and a pressure gauge, the CPU, centrifugal pump and motor, ceiling fan, printer, bicycle, two-stroke petrol engine. So if you see all these 10 products, so if you see the part wise, here we can see more than 300 parts. And if you see the material, it will be more than 50 kind of materials. It starts from ferrous, non-ferrous, and various grades of plastic, composites. So all these rubber, all these products, when they dismantle, they will be able to understand, they can visualize the different materials used in various engineering applications. And also they will be understanding different mechanisms, whether the hydraulic jack. So they understand the Boyle's law, how it works, they will understand. And the iron box. So many of the students excited after seeing this iron box, what is inside, then after seeing the heating element. So they excited to see. And in my experience, just I offered this course for nearly 200 students, 200 plus 200, 400 students in two years. So out of 400 students, 300 students, their first time they're dismantling CPU. They're seeing what are the parts inside the computer. And the centrifugal pump and motor. So many of them after dismantling, so they were excited and they were telling that if there is any requirement at my home, I am able to do that repair, I am able to do connections. So on the ceiling fan, so that very first time they see that the coil of the motor, they are excited. And the printer and bicycle. So the bicycle, there is the free wheel. They understood the concept of the free will after disassembly only. And the two-stroke petrol engine. So the carburetor, how it works. And they see, they said even the alloy, they were raising the questions. So that we give small, when we go rounds, then we'll tell that so that engine at the end of the compression of this petrol and air. So when it is ignited, the temperature of the air fuel mixture will be some 3000 degrees Celsius. So aluminium alloy is the cylinder casing and the cylinder head. So how the melting point of aluminium is only 700 degrees Celsius, how it withstand for this temperature. So these kind of questions we'll ask, and we are allowing them to use all the electronic gadgets like mobiles. They can Google it. If there is any doubt, they can Google it, then they will be able to find out. And we received very good feedback for this course. And the activity, if you look at the activity during the course, so disassemble the product physically and understand the function of each part, like material design, and make a note of it and reassemble it. So then they have to understand on history of the, even we'll ask them to find out the history of the product. For example, if you take iron box, So Ironworks some 20 years before, just we will be able to see that the weight of the Ironworks is very high. Okay, now that they will be able to compare the history of the Ironworks from very first model to the latest model in the available in the market, and the origin of idea. So they will be able to, during that time they are allowed to use mobile, and they will be able to find out what is the patent on this particular product technology. That also we will find out, and what is the theory behind its working. So they will understand how it works, and materials. So the materials, see, they see even till their higher secondary, they know only a steel. Steel means that it's a carbon and iron. So then they say that other elements, we can see the steel same. If you take a stainless steel or other carbon steel, low carbon steel, miles, see, they can see all are steel, but they will be able to visualize grades of that steel. And then they will Google it, they will find out that, oh, stainless steel means these are all the compositions. Oh, this is, oh, it's not getting rusted. So the reason is because of these elements. So during that time, we slowly, like a story, we tell them and we'll understand. The life cycle. So during the product also, they will understand the life cycle of the product. And I will ask them to submit the report at the end of the activity. Even during the class itself. And also we'll ask them to write improvisation, the scope for improvisation of the product and updating the product. Suppose if they have anything on their mind for new innovation or new updates in the product, then we'll ask them to check, is there any patent on this improvisation of the product. So it creates a lot of interest to them. And this electrical wiring, so we'll ask them to understand the circuit diagram and various symbols of the electrical components and list of components, and assemble the component as per the circuit diagram, check the circuit before testing, and also they go to test. Since we used to operate at 230 volts, so we ask them to give to instructor before testing by them. So these are the report submission, and you can see some of the photographs taken during the course by the students. So you can see the hydraulic jack, and this is that iron box, and this is electrical wiring, and you can see the dismantling of CPU. And another activity I initiated at IIT Madras is engineering is fun. To the school children. So here main motivation is the paucity of proper infrastructure, especially in rural and suburban areas. And infrastructure development will remain the most important wing of the development in India. And there is a big void in creative and innovative engineering in India. So that is the reason in particular manufacturing, so we are depending on many foreign countries for some critical products. So India ranks among the lowest in the global skilled manpower list. So we need to strengthen skills in general engineering thinking. And there is a need to bridge the gap between the bookish knowledge and with the real life experience. The big picture thinking and the experimental experiential thinking are largely missing. So there is a need to tap the interest and talent early, especially among the rural and suburban kids, and provide strong foundation and shaping future engineers early, encouraging self-learning. So motivation here is, so 2011, I went to Germany to participate in a conference. So there, the Hanover is one of the cities in Germany, and Hanover Messe is famous. That's a big exhibition hall in Hanover. So I went to that exhibition hall, and it's like a machine tool, all the products, in particularly machine tools and measuring instruments. So I went there, and one of the person was purchasing the tabletop CNC lathe and milling machine. Then I was asking, why are you buying this tabletop one? Why not you are buying actual one? Then he told me that, no, my son is 13 years old. So just I want to create small workshop at the home so that you will get all the skills. So then that was my beginning to create the same kind of skills to our children. And this was the activity we started in 2013 in the beginning. And objective of that workshop is, So create interest in engineering with an emphasis on targeting suburban and rural school children. But if you see the many of the city schools, they introduce this robotics class and so many other extracurricular activities. In particular, suburban and rural areas, so it is missing in India. And also demonstrate various features of our infrastructure under their design. And nurture innovative and creative aspects of simple design ideas, introduce self-learning methods, and hands-on engineering in woodworking, basic circuitry, and major areas. And also during that time, we introduced the gear drives, the mechanical elements like pulleys, cams, piston and sliding mechanisms, like the electrical and water, environmental awareness, safety. So various large and small engineering systems we introduced during that time. And methodology is a suburban kids it's like a SATAM training program at IIT premises. So we invite them to IIT. And the age group between 13 to 15. And we initiated for 5 batches per year, 5 different schools. And rural children, we thought of creating a mobile mini workshop van so that we will equip with all these hands-on tools so that the van will go to the village and they can demonstrate there. And the 4 days workshop with these are all the activities. So machine and mechanisms, and design and implementation, electrical fundamentals, and the fluid fundamentals. So these are all the activities in each one. And you can see the some of the photographs. Here in activity, so we gave activity so that we gave that you have to make your own dream model car. The maximum size is 1 foot. And initially we asked them to make their own design. So then, and also we gave the scripting pad and they started making their own design. And during that time, we tell them that you take the scale and 1 feet means how much millimeter. So then you have to feel the dimensions and they have to inches, millimeters, centimeters. Also they feel during that time and they make a freehand sketch. So the side plate, bottom plate, wheels. So wheels means what is the size of the wheel, the aspect ratio, what should be the width of the car, width of the length of the car, and what should be the wheel size. So this thing, kind of thing they do during the sketching. And after the sketching, they'll bring, so my dream car is equivalent to this one. So this is my one. And then we'll ask them to, we'll give the wooden planks and preferably in plywoods. And we ask them to make the same marking in the wooden pieces. And we'll ask them, we ask them to cut the wooden pieces with the help. So normally, if the students are children are from 13 to 15 years, then with our technical staff, we'll ask them to handle the tools to get the experience. For small children, then we operate it and we'll give the parts and they nail it. We'll ask them to do nailing. So at the end of the nailing, so you can see that some of the cars, so rolled out cars of the children. Now you can see the happiness at the end. And you can see we'll ask them to do maintenance of the bicycle. So yeah, we'll give various features of the bicycles and they do it. And some electrical circuit activity. And also we introduce them what is 3D printer. So you can see the demonstration of the 3D printer. So here it is very interesting. The very first day we demonstrated 3D printing to them. Next day morning, just 8:30, I saw girl student, she's from IIT campus. She brought a big bag with the lunch. Then I asked her, is there any activity here? She told, no, uncle, I want to say, yesterday you demonstrated 3D printer. So today I wanted to stay here and I brought lunch. I wanted to understand complete what is 3D printing. So we give some more activities and you can look at this boy. So he was under a hand fracture. And with that, because of the interest, all the way he came to this workshop and he attended it. We also introduced pneumatic circuits during this workshop. And you can see some more photographs. I think you can see we demonstrated them to how lathe works, woodworking, and you can see sanding. So even the students are working on sander. Okay, and you can see also we have a very good technical team, and we used to visit some village schools, and you can see then we in front of them just we demonstrated various things, and we made some kind of food stands there, and we handed over to them. So here when we were doing instructing the students, and there the previous day there was a rain. And one of our staff went to touch the wall to for something. One child came and he said, "Sir, don't touch the wall. And during the rainy day, if anyone touches the wall, we get electric shock." Then we were shocked about it. Then we asked him, "What is the reason?" Then the teacher came and said, "No, sir, this building was constructed 3 years before. So there, that electrical wiring they did the tube light is not working there, and the tube light frame, there is a wire cut in the frame, and whenever there is a rainy day, then there is a water leakage through the wall. So then it will then there will be electric shock we are getting." Then immediately then we attended, since we are with a very good technical team, we attended the problem, and this is the scenario. And there's even 2 days after, just I saw one news in the newspaper that one of the government schools in Tamil Nadu, so that the particular rainy day, the student went to the pump room in the school, and when he tried to switch off the pump and he got electric shock, he died in the spot. So this is the scenario in our government schools in the village, in particular in the villages. So these are all the expected outcome from this kind of engineering workshop. A strong foundation in engineering thinking right from a young age among the rural and suburban kids. The hands-on training gives children a feel for their engineering, and more importantly, to be able to connect why they learn in their school science and math and civic lessons and outside world. So they will start to observe the engineering side things and systems. In the long run, it could provide a set of real and enthusiastic engineers from the rural India that will build an India with much needed and fundamental engineering infrastructure in the villages. Okay, so thank you very much. You can ask your questions now.
So thank you for your powerful session, sir. So really you have done a lot of innovative projects, especially for the society oriented. So really it is an impressive one, sir. Thank you. So now the session is open for the participant. Now the sir is available. You can interact or you can ask the questions related to the product development or product design. Or you can post the question in the chat box. We are ready to read you. Okay, sorry, we are just unmute. Now you can talk to sir.
Sir, very good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, Dr. Nilesh Avate.
Yes, sir, please tell me, please, sir.
Yes, sir, your session is so nice, and those information shared by you and your work is so so good, sir. I continue to with you. We are also develop a tinkering lab in our college.
Oh, great, sir.
We also focus student of 12th standard as well as 8th standards.
Okay.
For nurturing the innovation and creativity of them.
Okay, sir.
So, but other side, we also focus on the faculty, but a teacher. Okay. Those are exclusively teaching to 9th standard as well as 12th standard.
Oh, great, sir, great.
So we are give training to them regarding to the innovative project, because they are always participating in the science festival and science related exhibitions. but they don't know the mechanical side and they don't know the information about the product design. So about this, I once I required your some guidance.
Sure, so, sir. So you are from which? We are from which part, sir?
Sir, G.H. Rayasuni College of Engineering, Nagpur. It is an autonomous institute in Nagpur. We have 139 NRF ranking and second in utter ranking. Utter innovation ranking, we have got second rank, Pan India.
Oh.
So that's why in our college, innovation and creativity culture is so high. A separate innovation cell, we will take complete care about the hackathons and other activity.
Great, sir. Yes,
but side by side, we also focus on the faculty of science colleges and other colleges, because the real innovator is come from the school.
Schools.
It is our intention. So that's why we are focused on them and creating some solution and creating some problems and give to them to submit to us. But meanwhile, while working, it is observed that if the faculty are not aware about this, so why students are working? So that's why we specially design one course for the teacher and conducting various innovative project related activity at our college. So in continue to this, I require your some suggestion.
Sure,
shall
sir.
We give problem to dear directly societal problem to them or any other innovative problem to them?
Sir, the giving societal problem is very, very important, sir. They ought to understand empathy on society.
Yes, yes. Because you are totally focused on societal problem. I had complete last 1.5 hours. I see each and everything during your presentation.
Yes, sir.
A nice and small problem you pick up.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Because this year also we are interested because Nagpur is a hub of bamboo. Because in our so that's why we are totally focused on creating some articles and creating some home appliances by utilizing the bamboo, because it is a so lightweight device and life is so good, and various design we are properly creating on there, one 3D as well as 2D.
Okay, but sir, there is a one institute in Jammu, so they work on bamboo products.
Okay, okay. So yeah, there is so that's why we are totally in the stage of developing a tickering lab.
Okay.
Total tickering lab at our college.
Okay,
but special innovation shall totally dedicated to with a 7 to 8 faculty, and we are always encouraged to student, because it is a future of India. Innovation is a future of India.
Yes, sir. Sir, better to focus for the first year students, so that once they get interest in the first year, so they will be able to spend a good time their remaining years.
Okay, okay. Sir, that's why about this, I need your some guidance. If you...
Sure, sir. Sure, sir.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, sir. So, if it is possible, so I drop mail to you. Otherwise, Gopinath, sir, I call to Gopinath, sir, our organizer, about your contacts.
Yes, sir. I will
sir. It's a so nice presentation and more interesting presentation, sir.
Thank you.
Nice. Thank you very much.
So thank you, sir. Any other question from the participant side? So Gurpreet ma'am. Ma'am, are you available? Gurpreet ma'am?
Yes, sir. I'm very much available. Trying to take in all the engineering knowledge and, trying to put it in my mind so that I can utilize it for my students, because I am in a CBSE school. So just trying to grasp everything. I really appreciate the way sir explained with small examples. And for me, the key takeaway for today would be dissemination or probably destruction as a road to innovation. So I think we have to thank sir for that. So thank you so much, sir, for that really interesting and innovative session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. One more thing we had forgot to introduce in our speaker. So actually, Dr. Balaganesan sir is the instrument for set up the IIT Tirupati, IIT Hyderabad, and the IIT Kalakar. So he's only established the central workshop for those the IITs and all. And previously we worked at IIT Jammu also. So he's very passionate of research, especially society-oriented project. And he's also a special expert, especially in the area of nanocomposite materials.
And also just I want to give my one more, I think we have two more minutes. And I think all of us know in India, about 80% of atoms, the hanging atoms using ceiling fan. So we have developed a device we called HK-Naught in our the company product name. It's a safety device for ceiling fan. So here, if you fix the device between the U-hook and top of this the tube of ceiling, so the ceiling fan. So when anyone tries to attempt by hanging through ceiling fan, so then it will drop them to the floor. So that without even the fan will not hit on their head. Only thing, it will drop them in the floor. And the cutoff weight is about 35 kg. So if you look at any child or anyone of age 13 or 15, their weight will be more than 35 kg. So that we have designed the device. And we have installed about 5,000 rooms of IIT Madras hostel rooms and 2,500 hostel rooms of IIT Hyderabad, about 600 rooms of IIT Tirupati. If anyone is interested to get these devices to install it, so the cost is only 150 rupees. The ceiling fan cost is 1,200. So you wanted to bring close to 10% of ceiling fan. So it is about 150. And also we have installed some more devices in some arts colleges in South Tamil Nadu, Madurai and other places. So if anyone is interested, you can always contact us.
Okay, thank you, sir. So once again, I thank you for accepting our invitation and spending your valuable time with us. I thank all the participants who patiently attending the last session of the day 3. And I put a kind request. So all of you fill the feedback form which is posted in the chat box. So don't leave without filling the feedback. Thank you. So Bala sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you for giving the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. If you wish, you can sign out, sir.
Sure, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.